Hello Lego fans, this is Brett92, and this is actually the first Lego kit I have ever built in at least 20 years, literally. I think, actually more than that, I think the last kit I built was 1992. So, yeah, it's been over 20 years since I've built a Lego kit. And this is from the Creator Set, it is number 31027, the blue race car, 67 pieces. I thought I'd start small. And the fact that it is 3-in-1, like, they actually give you instructions to build all three different ones. And yeah, I paid $7 for it. So you've got the race car. More of a go-kart, which I think a Lego figure could fit in. And kind of like a plow vehicle. So, I'm not going to do like I did with the Tails figure, because it was actually just a static figure. It was pointless to actually show it off, so I built it, where I can actually show all three different modes. So we're going to first look at the blue race car. Kind of cool. I like it. It's very small. It has rubber tires. It rolls very freely. Oopsie. It stays together very well. And it looks pretty good. I kind of wish these were like, I don't know if Lego makes a long clear section. But it looks a little weird with four little separate ones, but that's okay. No big deal. But it does look pretty good. It has an opening trunk, so you actually get it out of the engine, which is pretty neat. I like how the hinge is there, so you have the flat part on the back. That is pretty cool. That was a neat little, actually, separate part to build onto it. So it was a very neat little assembly. Now, there are also a few traffic cones that you get with it, that you build. So definitely like a racy little scene. And these are the parts you have left over. A little blue, white, like a little silver, a clear red, and a little clear smoky gray like the windshield, and also from the lights. So the first build is pretty good. I really like it. It was very easy. It took me like 2 minutes to build. And yeah, I really like that part. That is kind of cool. Show inner detail. So I really like this build. Let's go on to the... We will build the little, like, plow vehicle next. So I will be right back with that. And here is the, what I guess I call a plow, pretty much. It still rolls fine. It has a little siren up here, maybe, I don't know what that is, maybe like a gas tank or something. And I like the fact that the plow part actually lifts up and down. Very nice. I'm not a big fan of the window piece here, or lack thereof, because you can see it's hollow. They only had the wedge pieces to work with, so not much they can really do. And, well, I guess in the picture it shows that it's basically using the cones here and just pushing them, so I guess that's what it is, like a plow sort of vehicle. So if there's like an accident, they could push that out of the way. Push up all the dead bodies, get them out of the way. Now, you still have all these parts left over from the initial build, but now you've got even more. That's a good chunk of the race car that isn't used anymore. So what I did is I just put it together like this and you stick it on the back. And there you go. And now it actually looks more like a race car itself, but at least these parts are used. Still have these, but it's not as bad. But that's not the official build, so I'll just put it right back together. And definitely not my favorite out of the two so far. But we still have one more to go, and that is the go-kart. So let's get on to that. And here is the third and final build, the go-kart. And holy crap, is this thing small. This is the fewest parts used in the set. Although I really like it. I do like the way it's designed. It's very simple. And it is effective. It goes. It's a card. I like the adjustable seat. You could put a minifigure in this one. Could do it with the other two. I don't have any to show off yet. That will change, I promise. But it doesn't look too bad. Got like the engine back here, the exhaust pipes and everything. But yeah, it is the one that has the least amount of pieces. Like, I mean, this little table, you can put like the pylons on and maybe like a canister or something. And we got these parts. Now, I actually decided to bolt this guy up. Not really that hard. I mean, it simply, you just put these on here, which are used on the front of the car and the back of the plow. You know, just for something, but what I decided to do, get rid of the exhaust, get rid of the top of the engine block, that off, and then add this piece here to bulk up the front, and then add the fenders, and then take this whole thing and just plug it into the back, and then you can take the parts here, put the exhaust back on, and then this part can kind of go here to fill in the middle, and then I just put these here to remove the studs, and now you got a bigger go-kart with like a huge spoiler, pretty much. You have like a couple of drinks or people sitting on there. But yeah, so that's what I did, because it was just, it had so little pieces. But still, I think, because this one can actually use a minifigure, this is my favorite design. Or at least my favorite, yeah, my favorite design, I think, but not my favorite build. Favorite build would definitely have to be the blue car, because it actually incorporates almost all the pieces, aside from five little ones. And the plow is just, it's alright, it does function, but it is kind of abstract looking, in a way. So, yeah, I just like this because it is small, and I think if they'd actually made this as a separate build by itself without extra pieces, that would have been okay. But it is nice to have the other two options. So, all in all, as my first Lego kit in over 20 years, I like it. I like it a lot. And definitely gonna have more in the future, for sure. I have become a little addicted to this now. So that is about it, and I'll see you in the next review.